Have you ever really craved Mexican food on a keto diet but felt you couldn't eat it?
Do you miss your tacos? Well, we got a solution for you. What you're looking at here is a keto cheese taco, and they are awesome. Stay tuned, you're not gonna wanna miss this.
I'm Bridget, I'm a school librarian, lover of books, dogs, and food, and aspiring keto chef.
And I am Dan Perryman, I'm a former hospital CEO turned entrepreneur, and host of Low Carb Leader podcast and YouTube channel. And in this video, we are going to show you how to make the most amazing keto cheese tacos.
Okay, so right now we're going to mix the 2 cups of cheese, and we used Mexican cheese, and half a teaspoon of ground cumin, and I am really going to, this is a teaspoon, so I'm going to do half of this, and I am a real guesstimator when it comes to this, kind of mixing herbs and spices. It's going to make it have a real nice punchy flavor to it. Yay, that's all you do for that. And then the next step is, I've got, this is going to go in the oven. So, some kind of baking tray or something like that, and parchment paper here. And then you're just going to put, this is really easy, just kind of piles of the cheese and just kind of smooth it out. And you just want there to be kind of, and this makes 8 tacos, but we're gonna just show you how to do this for 4 today. You know, the piles should be even, and you're just making little cheese piles, making it as flat as you can, because these taco shells will be composed primarily of cheese. And who doesn't like crunchy cheese? So this is ready to go in the oven. Now I preheated the oven to 400. We're gonna put them in there. Okay, so this is the shrimp mixture we made with the taco seasoning, 1 pound, and I just got this frozen shrimp from Trader Joe's, and it was seriously under $10. So it was already cooked too. And I also used Pensy's taco seasoning, and so it's just really delicious taco seasoning with on the shrimp, so really yummy. So that will go in our tacos, and you could of course use ground beef, chicken, whatever you want to use. Okay, these are my 4 keto taco shells that I made. Taking this out, I'm gonna move it on my rack. I'm just using an oven rack. So you don't have to buy anything special. We were like, okay, let's show people how to do this without having to buy anything special. So I let it cool just a little bit, and then once it cools a little bit, I'm gonna drape it over the edge to mold it into a taco shell. I'm gonna move this cup a little bit. Oops, both hands. I mean, this is very versatile. You could just put this straight and make these into chips, crunchy, yummy chips to snack on throughout the day when you want something crunchy. You can make yourself think that you're eating potato chips or corn chips. You could make a taco bowl by shaping it into the shape of the bowl. You would probably want to use a bowl this size, or make your taco shell a little bigger, because that could make a nice taco salad for you. You can also make really small ones and drape them over for like little appetizers. I'm gonna explain this delicious Chipotle aioli I made to go as a sauce on the tacos, because you know, whenever you get a yummy street taco or something like that, they always have yummy sauce, and it really is a yummy addition to your tacos. Okay, so I've got my yummy taco ready to go. And you just do this however you want to do it. Everybody's taco is going to be different. So, just adding a generous amount of shrimp that I'm getting all over the place, but that's the beauty of tacos, they're messy. And I'm going to add my little aioli. And I mean, isn't it great, just a combination of a delicious sauce with the crunchiness of the taco shell and the savoriness of the shrimp. And so I'm going to add this. Add some tomato, and you can add some salsa. And I'm gonna put, I'm using my fingers, forgive me, but I'm doing it. I'm gonna put on some avocado. Put a little cilantro. Oh, so I'm spilling everywhere. And some lime, how yummy. It's gonna be the best ever. Oh my God, look at this beauty.